Just like it's on scripture, so I'm going to relay unto them and paraphrase them as we'll be moving. And one thing that we must understand in this kingdom that we represent, we have victories and we win according to the level of grace that functions for our lives, as well as according to the possibilities that you command in the heavenly places. In this kingdom where we are, we win our battles again according to the level of understanding that you possess, scriptural understanding, revelational understanding, as well as your access to the mysteries and the secrets of God. When you have got much access to the secrets and the mysteries of God, you are guaranteed victory in your life.
Amen.
And if you command graces, as we always say that grace is dimensional, you always win again. The difference between Saul and David is that David had grace, Saul had rank. That's why David had to prevail over Saul. So it's not only rank that is going to make you to rise up and command strange results in your life. All men are really the same except for three factors that I want you to put down. We are all the same except for three factors. According to God's class, we are the same. We've been called the same, anointed the same, created the same. But these are three factors that I've just meditated and I came up with. Because there's been a question to me and say, why is it we have a disparity in the body of Christ? There are those that prophesy so much, there are those that move in signs and wonders, and there are those that preach with power, with revelation, and I've just computed three factors that makes and that puts that line of demarcation and distinction between men. The first factor is the quality of revelation and information you have access to. This is the first distinction factor that separates men into spiritual cadres. The quality, not the quantity, the quality of revelation and information you have access to. That's the first factor. Number two factor, the quality of relationship that provides the leverage for you at the level that your enlightenment has taken you. I'll take it again. The quality of relationship or relationships that provides the leverage for you at the level that your enlightenment has taken you. And one thing that you must understand is that knowledge, as you get knowledge, knowledge is like a ladder. So when you rise up, you find out that you are not alone at a certain level that you've risen up to. There are other people that are already there. So when that knowledge has made you to rise up, you will have relationships that you have that will provide leverage for you. Which means if I have a relationship with an influential person in South Africa, it provides leverage to me. If I've got a relationship with the president, it provides a leverage for me. So knowledge leads you, and there are some relationships that comes there in honor of that enlightened vision. So when knowledge has lifted you, there are relationships that comes to you in honor to that enlightenment. Number three factor, the quality and dimension of spiritual empowerment that is upon your life is what really makes you different from other people. I'll take it again, quality and dimension of spiritual empowerment that is upon your life. So if we remove these factors, all men are exactly the same, predictably the same. There are possibilities that may not happen again on the strength of a certain light that you have, and there are possibilities that comes following a certain light that you have. That's why the Bible says, arise and shine, for your light is come. Gloomy darkness shall cover the people, and that darkness shall cover the nation. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and Gentiles shall be attracted to your light, and kings to the brightness of your light. Which means if you rise up in light, you attract people that are ordinary people, general people. You attract people that are not of influence. So you may have light, but that light can attract people with no influence, people with no money. But when your light is bright, that's when you can attract princes and kings and presidents. So it answers your question that I know God, I have good light, but why is it I'm not attracting people of power, people of influence? You need to pray that your light may be brighter so as to attract the people of influence. Five scriptural reasons why people lose. That's the message that I have today. And these reasons, they capture both the training of the believer and a caution to a careless one. These reasons, they capture all the dimensions of a believer, and they caution those that are careless again, who are not believers. Number one, the first reason according to scripture why people lose is lack of discernment. Somebody shout discernment. Hebrews chapter 2, subsection 1. The Bible says, since all this is true, according to Hebrews chapter 2, verse 1, since all this is true, we ought to pay much closer attention than ever to the truth that we have heard, lest in any way we drift past them and slip away. So it was while men slept that an enemy came and planted tears, satanic and demonic seeds. Why? Because when a person is sleeping, you lack discernment. There are people that are sleeping spiritually and you can't discern. Discernment is the greatest gift that God gives to apostles. Apostles are not only there to plant churches, but apostles, they have been anointed, ordained with the discernment. So when an apostle comes to a territory where an apostle has been called to prophesy, the apostle must have discernment to discern the graces that are lacking upon a certain territory. He has the ability to discern again the grace that are available upon a certain territory. So that's the greatest gift that an apostle has. So when he senses that, inasmuch as I'm supposed to prophesy, but where I am, people are lacking in terms of spiritual empowerment, he comes and empower. When he comes and realizes that people are lacking in the area of prayer, he comes and helps people with prayer. So that's the greatest gift that is given to apostles. So as a child of God, you must have discernment. While people were sleeping, the devil came to plant. Which means in your garden, your spiritual garden, you are not the only farmer that is in that garden. There are other farmers that are in your garden. Which means when you are tilling your spiritual garden, you must know that there are other seeds that the devil come and plant. Know that even when you put a seed physically, know that there are other planters that are going to put seeds on the ground. So discernment now, it helps you to start now to pick those things that are godly and things that are demonic, things that are profitable and things that are not profitable. So you see,